I'm Martin Flaunet. I'm an audit partner within Deloitte Audit here in Luxembourg. I'm in charge of the audit banking practice, and I'm also leading the Basel III initiative here in Luxembourg.
I am Laurent Berliner, partner within our enterprise risk services practice, where I'm more specifically in charge of governance and risk management services. And today we're going to talk about central administration, internal governance, and risk management requirements set forth by CSSF Circular 12552 for banks and investment firms.
The Circular 12552 is one of the elements of response to the governance issues that have been known throughout the financial crisis that we know that we have been through since 2007. More specifically, it's the implementation within the Luxembourg law, within the Luxembourg framework of the GL44, which is the guidelines on internal governance issued by the European Banking Authority. On top of this, the CSSF took the opportunity to consolidate all existing requirements in this circular, which was a comment from the review from the IMF and a strong comment also from the industry since a couple of years.
This circular supersedes and replaces six existing circulars, but it would be misleading to say that this document is revolutionizing the regulatory framework already in place for banks and investment firms. Rather, it does centralize in one single document all the key requirements related to governance and risk management. Actually, the circular frames a number of new requirements that are, for most of them, even sometimes not formally documented, already in place for banks, but that were not so far explicitly stated in the regulatory framework.
The major new requirements are related to the composition of the board of directors. Whereas in the past, the repute was the main focus of the regulators, it's moving to fit and proper testing with individual fitness for the member of the boards, but also collective fitness. The second part of the new requirements is related to the creation of three new functions: chief risk officer, IT officer, and information security officer, that need to be in place on the 1st of July this year. Also, and not the least, is the annual confirmation from the executive management to the CSSF that the requirements of this circular are complied with.
I believe this is a great opportunity for banks and investment firms to overhaul their governance and risk management structure and functioning. As the circular requires the authorized management to annually confirm to the CSSF that their organization complies with all the aspects of the circular, a gap analysis will anyway be necessary to support this management assertion. Such readiness assessment will probably result in a number of gaps in terms of governance organization mechanism or infrastructure, as well as in terms of documentation to be upgraded or better formalized. I hope and trust that this exercise will not be applied as a mere, I would say, tick-the-box compliance exercise, but more wisely be taken as an opportunity to reconsider and streamline the governance and risk management structure and optimize interaction within the organization to enhance efficiency and therefore limit the cost associated.